PowerPoint is an excellent presentation tool, but there are a few simple rules you need to follow if you're going to create a really great presentation. In this short video, we'll explain them. The first rule before you even get to use PowerPoint is to edit your script down to short, clear, simple statements. A written script is essential if you're going to transmit your ideas clearly. For PowerPoint, less is more. People can read simple bullet points on a screen, but will struggle to read whole sentences. And remember, your audience will be reading the words on the screen. So if you're speaking, you need to use the same words. There's nothing more confusing than reading one set of words and hearing a different set. Okay, now let's open up PowerPoint. If it's the first time you've used it, you'll be offered automatic updates, and it's a good idea to accept them. Next, there's a simple tour of the software and a set of possible templates for you to play with. For now, let's build our own. You'll learn more that way. Once you have your script, you need to prepare a master slide or template. Although PowerPoint is capable of very complex designs, even to producing a graphic video, the point of a presentation is to convey information clearly and simply, not dazzle people with your design skills. There's nothing more off-putting than an over-designed or badly designed PowerPoint presentation. Keep it simple, keep it clear, and keep attention. There are four elements to a presentation. The first element is the text or script. And for text, you need a clear font. Research on which particular font is easiest to read is inconclusive. I prefer a sans-serif font, so that's what I use. What is conclusive is that size matters. No smaller than 30 point. The font should not get in the way of the information, so be consistent. Use no more than two different fonts, one for headlines, one for text. And by default, PowerPoint uses Calibri, and I'm happy to stick with that. Here's an example using PowerPoint's default Calibri font. Note that anything smaller than 30 point is going to be very difficult to read from any distance. Next, good contrast between the font and the background is essential, but don't overdo it. To start this exercise, I've chosen a blue-grey font on a white background. I love white. It breathes space. It's important that your slides are visually consistent, not hopping about from one font to another or one design to another. And you can create consistency easily in PowerPoint by using PowerPoint's template system. The slide templates can be arranged down the left side of the screen. Set up a template with your chosen font and background, and each time you add a slide, your font and background will be the same. My practice is to set up two or three most used templates, but to create others if I need them. That way, I save time. The second element is visual design. People learn differently. Some people learn from words, others learn from pictures, yet again others from listening, and others also learn from seeing something working. PowerPoint can cope with all four. Start with the words, the good script, and you can add pictures or graphic elements like graphs to explain your argument. For the listeners, you can add a soundtrack, but remember to use the same words as are on the screen. And you can even add a short video. If you only use words, your presentation will be boring and will lose the attention of most of your audience very quickly. A sparing addition of graphics, pictures, even humour if appropriate, can help to keep attention. You'll often be required to include the company logo. If it's going to be on every slide, add it to the master slide for consistency and ease of use. But be careful when you're adding pictures. Copyright law applies to online images just as much as print images, and just grabbing an image from the internet may land you and your company in trouble. If you're promoting a company or product, they'll often be glad to have their images or logo in front of people, so if you ask first, you may well get permission. And remember to credit them. Send an email and keep a copy. And there's plenty of free clip art around too. Here's how to insert a picture. Part of the magic of PowerPoint is its ability to create interesting animations between the elements of a slide and transitions between the slides themselves. You'll find the Transitions tab and the Animations tab along the top bar. You can add an animation like this. And between slides, you can add transitions like this. The third element to your PowerPoint presentation is sound. It can be just your own commentary, or you can add music or a recorded commentary to your PowerPoint. Here's how. The fourth and final element is the printed notes. You can add footnotes or a full commentary to each and every slide and print them out as handouts after your presentation. And if you don't fancy doing the design yourself, there are many different templates you can buy or download for free from the internet. Microsoft PowerPoint, brought to you by eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our more recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.